On my very first delegation, when I started at UK Israel Business 6 years ago, we saw, I think, 40 companies in 3 days. And at the end of that trip, I'd never seen, really had much exposure to Israeli high tech before. I made a list of, I think, 5 companies that I really rated over the next period of time. And I've kept track of them. And one of them is actually Riskified. And it's been wonderful to see their growth over the years. And I think they're now valued well into the hundreds of millions of dollars and doing fabulous stuff. And they were one of the most impressive companies when we took our delegation with MasterCard back in November. So it really is a great pleasure to invite Meirav Peled from Riskified to speak. Thank you very much, Meirav.
Hi. So that was a warm welcome. I'm Meirav. Thank you all for being here. And I'll pick up, I'm not a millennial as you can see, but I did know I was coming into London a couple of weeks ago, and coming in from Tel Aviv and having some UK shops that I love, I actually went online over the weekend and bought a few things so I can pick them up here. And I actually found everything I wanted and used all the discounts in the store, and I chose at the checkout pickup in the store, because when I come in for just a couple of days to London, I want to know that I can pick up my package. And I actually landed yesterday evening, and I immediately went to the store and to pick up my stuff, which was very exciting because everything was ready for me. And as I was sorting through it, I realized that one of the shirts that I got was in the wrong size. Quickly enough, someone went and grabbed the right size shirt for me, and I was happy, and I said, can I just exchange them? And then something a bit strange happened. I was told I needed to go back online, cancel the order that I had, and rebuy it online. Okay, I went online, I canceled. Now when I wanted to buy it again, all of a sudden on my mobile, I was prompt with what you guys here in the UK love, 3D secure, meaning I now need a code from my SMS, from my mobile phone, in order to finish the purchase. To make a long story short, it got frustrating and annoying because I didn't get my code and I couldn't finalize it. So I think what I'm trying to say is, yes, millennials are trying to see how they can be in the center of everything, and not being a millennial, me too, I love that. So we are in the middle of an e-commerce revolution, and we do want the great winning customer success story. And here's an example where it was a bit off, and we'll see why it's important for all the merchants out there. So as I move forward and presented myself already, Riskified, where do we come into this winning customer and millennial centering? So Riskified is actually an e-commerce solution that was based on the notion of boosting revenue and making sure the brand reputation is enhanced and kept, because we all want to have a great customer success story. So we have products and services to help these merchants drive more revenue, get higher approval rates, get that winning customer story. And we work with merchants to make sure they don't suffer from fraud, but also that they don't suffer from the fear of fraud. And I'll talk a bit about what that means later on. We also assume all the chargeback liability on e-commerce. So we shift liability to us, offering a full chargeback guarantee. And we do that with one thing in mind. We want to make sure that the experience that customers have with these global brands, and this is kind of my show-off slide, so you can see the global brands that we're working with, and we are in charge of making sure that they drive more and more revenue through their purchase funnel. They work very hard at bringing these customers online. They work very hard at moving them along the website. What happens at checkout? We know they lose a lot of customers there. So we're here to help them make the journey a successful one, turn the shopper into a happy customer. So let's dive a bit deeper into this purchase funnel. And I'm going to talk today about how this innovation and technology actually can boost and enhance the online shopping journey and increase the funnel. So I'm going to jump quickly into some background. Where is e-commerce going? We're right here at the Amazon headquarters. We know that offline and online, maybe not tomorrow, but surely in a couple of years, gonna get into an equilibrium, right? We see Amazon buying Whole Foods. We see e-commerce merchants do pop-up stores. They all want to be everywhere, and they all want the experience to be the same experience, whether they're offline or online. It's very key. And we see that globally, but we also see it on a European scale. So as e-commerce is growing in double digits, we know from this Edgar and Dunn survey that it's going to grow in the next 5 years in double digits as well. And what's driving this growth? It's actually customers. So we have demands. Millennials really want everything centered around them, and they're driving these merchants to make the experience better. They want them to bring more innovation. So I want to shop globally and pay locally. I want to sometimes use an alternative payment and sometimes pay in installments. I want to sometimes pick up in the airport something that I bought, but I might want to exchange it at the store right next to my house. And on top of all of these, the customers want not to be stopped anywhere along the line. They don't want friction. They want to move very quickly and seamlessly through the transaction. That's really key. And this brings immense opportunity not only to the merchants, but also to their entire ecosystem. So to the banks, to the PSPs, to everyone in this room, actually, because we are driving innovation. Let's look at Omnichannel as an example of driving innovation in the e-commerce world. And I think we'll all agree that 4 or 5 years ago, multi-channel was very different than what Omnichannel has evolved into. So multi-channel mean that the merchant had to have some kind of an online presence, maybe a mobile app. They both had to be nice, but it's okay if one looked one way and the other looked another way. Well, Omnichannel has evolved into something very, very different today. Let's look at what this shopper wants today. So as I said, they want to actually do whatever they want, whenever they want it, and wherever they want it, and they want to get the same experience. So whether I start shopping online, but then I'm in the store and I want to exchange, or whether I'm on my Instagram, on my Facebook, I want to shop. I want to have the same great experience. This is the focus. This is the key. Whether it's on my mobile or whether it's in the shop. Okay, and why is this key? It's because I want to be able to move from one experience to the other and still be happy, still have a winning experience. So, as you can imagine, what I had yesterday was not exactly that, but that's what's driving e-commerce. And with all my enthusiasm about the e-commerce revolution, we know that there's still a gap, and we can see why. If only 7% of retailers today can actually facilitate this omnichannel, then there's still a big gap. If we're hearing that 75% of retail executives are telling us they're going to invest in omnichannel in the next 5 years, there is still a gap. And what we want to make sure is that we stop these leaks in the purchase funnel. While there's a gap in the experience, we're also looking for payments to be very, very seamless, right? So we want to shop, but we want to make sure that the payment is in the background. We know that almost 260 million wearable devices are going to be active by 2023, meaning I can just pay with my watch. So yes, I want to have the experience, but I don't really want to deal with the payment. I want the payment to be in the background and not to feel it. It doesn't need to be center stage. So how do we make sure it's not center stage? That we can actually pay with a credit card or with an e-wallet or with a wearable item, but not stop anywhere along the line and switch between these things. Well, we need to make sure that we look at the data. And what do I mean by that? Well, at Riskified, we love data. we're a technology-driven company. But we want to make sure that we use all the data very quickly and behind the scenes. We don't want to stop any transaction. So we do everything in real time. We analyze. We use clickstream analysis, meaning we collect all the data at checkout. We also collect data from a beacon on the website, and we analyze everything very, very quickly. And I'm going to give you an example of one of this analysis. We use device fingerprinting. We use proxy detection. We use behavior analysis and real-time analysis. And we use all that to make the decisions and to take all the data to decide if this is a fraudulent transaction or not, to decide if this is a fear of fraud, meaning are we putting rules in place that stop legitimate customers? And we know that if we lose a legitimate customer, we don't lose them only for one transaction, but for a lifetime of transactions. And when we use the data to make real-time decisions, we're also using the data to make strategic decisions. And we're able to link all the information that we have with this data to make sure we can plan ahead. So it's not just looking at the transaction as a story and telling the merchant whether it's fraudulent or a good transaction, but we're actually telling the merchant what they can do in the future, because we see the customers and we understand their behavior, and 60% of their new customers are not new to us. So we can drive them through the purchase funnel. And I think that's the key. We want to use data to find the weak spots in the purchase funnel, and we want to stop them. And in order to do that, we need to look at data and we need to fix the leaks throughout the transaction. So I'm running out of time. I'll leave you with one key takeaway. There's a lot of data out there. It's not just about collecting it. It's about analyzing it, and it's about doing everything very quickly, whether it's looking at one transaction or whether it's looking at the overall strategy. Thank you so much.
Thank you very, very much indeed for a fascinating presentation. And it's been, as I said, wonderful to see the growth and the scale up of Riskified.